coming up here to northern Norway was a big dream for me. It's tough for the dark winter months, but it's still so beautiful and there's so much magic. I moved up here because I wanted to dive more.
Yes.
I was expecting a lot of life in the ocean. You'd be lucky if you'd see a crab, maybe a starfish here and there, but it was really rare to see a fish. Kelp is a key element in many ecosystems in the ocean, and when we're destroying so much of it, so we have to take action now. It's serious.
I guess I have a closer relation to the ocean by being born on the small island, Frøya. Now I've developed that passion for rowing, traditional rowing boats. It's a feeling of freedom. And it's also nice to not know where you end up. On land, we get all upset if there's a forest fire. Underwater too, you have forest fires. It can be a summer of extremely high temperature in one area, and it can wipe out entire kelp forests. In Sea Forester, our goal is to restore seaweed forests where they have disappeared. Take seaweed spores, spray them on these stones, and then we deploy. You can use the existing infrastructure, the fishing industry, for example, on the deployment process. The forests that provide a habitat for fish has been forgotten. And that link with fishing communities is very important because they have been forgotten too.
Here in northern Norway, urchins have taken over our ecosystems. Diving down was just urchin barrens everywhere. Due to overfishing and human activities, the urchin's predator has been removed from our oceans. So the urchins have been able to just explode in numbers and eaten down all the kelp and removed a really important ecosystem. Our organization is called Tarvaktere, which is in English, Guardians of the Kelp. We restore kelp forests here in northern Norway. And we go out with volunteer divers and we remove urchins from the area. Just by doing that, the ocean is able to restore itself. The kelp will grow back. Kelp is really good for carbon sequestration and biodiversity.
The kelp forest is what I like to call the kindergarten of the ocean.
A lot of different species come to feed. It's a nursery ground. This problem is massive, but there's very few people that actually know about it.
The disappearance of kelp forests is so serious that you need to think differently. It is crucial that people work closely together and participate.
I can't believe you're actually considering growing in those waves. That's nuts.
Oh, this is how they lived in the past. No roads, only boats.
Nearly all forms of life in the ocean touch the kelp forest at some point in time in their life cycle. If you lose kelp forests, you lose life in the ocean. Kelp forests are kind of the workhorses of the environment. This has to be addressed now because kelp forests are disappearing and nobody even knows about it as a problem.
A healthy ocean is absolutely critical to regulating the climate, providing food and livelihoods to billions of people.
Fish is a really nutritious ingredient in pet food. We recognise that it's important to look after this environment where we source from. We're working from the north of Norway all the way down to the south of Portugal and bringing together partners from that whole region to be able to share knowledge, to collaborate, to be able to scale more easily, more cost effectively, to be able to have a bigger impact.
I first learned about kelp forests and urchin crisis after the tsunami in 2011 in Japan. The tsunami washed away all the predatory species that kept the sea urchins in check. Urchinomics is all about kelp forest restoration. We're engaging communities, engaging fishers, engaging divers, like the guardians of the kelp, to help with the practical removal of the urchins. And by selling those sea urchins into the high-end restaurant markets, we create an economic incentive to remove them from the ocean floor, allowing the kelp forest to bounce back. Purina is actively engaging with urchinomics and other stakeholders, bringing the science together to restore kelp forests.
There's been so much focus on activities on land, but now it's really time to start focusing on our blue front yard.
Tadavoktere, or the guardians of the kelp, they are effectively being the eyes and ears for us under the water and showing how the ocean floor really looks like.
Purina is very proud to be working with such inspiring partners, to see the progress that we can make together and to be able to scale and make a wider impact across the region.
I am hopeful. What we're showing with the guardians of the kelp is we're able to restore an ecosystem in the ocean. We just need a bit of help from everyone to come in and do this together.